and what God needs for us in these days, it's important for us to know our identity.
That's right.
So that he can show us who we are, so that we can be, he spoke about being a community.
Yeah.
We have to be a community that people can come to, to get God to see the reflection of who he is. And to see to see that reflection and not the identity that the world is given. So it's so important. It's so important for us to deal with those things in our heart and to be confident in who he's showing us that we are. And I want to encourage you to what God has done. Don't underestimate what God has done in your life. He made you to be an overcomer. In some area of your life, he's made you to be overcome. Some of the songs said, we're staying in here only because he made a way. Because he removed a mountain in our life. He tore down a stronghold in our life. Only because he made that way are we standing here. So we could be we're here to be a community of overcomers, knowing our identity in him. So don't forget that. Don't underestimate in these last days who he's called you to be, who he's called you out of being, who he's called you out of being, who he's keeping you from being.
Yes.
Your identity in him.
Yes.
And who he's created you to be.
Yeah.
When I was in my youth, I walked in confusion of identity. This is the ministry about confusion of identity.
Yeah.
I walked as I thought that I was a lesbian. I took those relationships on. I walked in that identity. I walked as if I was in a masculine identity because of the things that I've been through in my life, because of rejection, because of hurts that I went through growing up. That confusion of identity, that lust attached itself to it. But I stand here today because God has delivered me from that. And not just delivered me out of it, but brought me through it and kept me in it. Almost every person that I know that came out of that life, went back to it, and is still in it today. Because of the strongholds of this world. So when God has delivered you from a stronghold in your life, don't underestimate it. Because it's his power that is keeping you standing right now. Thank you. It is not you that is keeping you standing here. Thank you. Whatever it is, don't underestimate what it is. If you're standing here today and you're single and you're not having sex, if you're not fornicating, it's because God is keeping you. If you're married and you're struggling and you've not committed adultery, it's because God's keeping you. Whatever strongholds that you had in your past that you're not walking in right now, don't underestimate. It's not that you're just not walking in it. You're walking in power that's keeping you from walking in it. You're walking in him that's keeping you from walking in everything else. So don't underestimate the power that is flowing through you to stand. So stand. When you say to put on the whole armor of God, stand. That armor is keeping you. That power is for us to bring out, to carry out. These are the last days that we have to walk, not just in here. It's not just for us to just come together, praise God, and go out. We go out with that power. We show others how to walk in that power. Go forth and make disciples, teaching them how to do what I taught you how to do. It is Yahusha that has brought healing and deliverance to us. He's the healing balm that met each one of us in our situations and in our circumstances. It's him that came to us in the flesh, that came to us and brought the Ruach to us so that we can walk out in his power. So embody that power. Embody that power. Be a community of that power. A community, because people need to. I encountered a sister who had came out of that life and found out that she went back to it. And I listened to her talk and it was like she was missing love. Why did she go back? She needed acceptance. She needed love. She needed a community. So people are out here looking like, I will leave this life. I will leave these drugs alone. I will stop having sex over here. I will stop doing this. I will stop doing these things if I just had a community that would embrace me with the power and the love of God. That's who we are called to be now. That's who we are called to embody. So don't take it lightly. Yes, we are keeping the Shabbat. We're coming back to his ways. Yes, we are coming into the feast days and getting deliverance and we're repenting. We're getting our vessels clean so we can be a clean vessel for his power and his love to flow through. So that we can walk in these last days so that we can be vessels of healing and deliverance and life and his love amongst each other and to be a community so that others will see a light they want to come to. So be encouraged in wherever Yah has brought you from. Take it not lightly, the things that you've gone through to keep you standing here today. Take it not lightly and continue in it. Continue in that power. Continue to walk. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.